It's Whatever Happened to Ace of Base? I'm John Beaudin from Rock History Book. We're going to start doing more videos in this series of musicians who sort of kind of not vanished, but they were so big, where did they go? In this case, it's Ace of Base.
Well, first of all, who was Ace of Base? They were a Swedish pop group formed in 1990 and originally consisted of siblings Jonas, Lynn, and Jenny Berggren with their friend Ulf Ekberg. And right off the bat, they received worldwide fame with their debut album, Happy Nation, in 1992. Who could forget The Sign? It was certified 9 times platinum in the United States and was the best-selling album of 1994. In Sweden, Ace of Base had 14 hit singles and 7 in the US. They were the 3rd top-selling band in Sweden after ABBA and Roxette, with an estimated sales of 45 million records worldwide. And to this date, they've released 5 studio albums and 28 singles. Ace of Base were the first group ever to debut at number 1 with a single and a number 1 album at the same time on the US Billboard charts. The band would go on and release studio albums until 2002, but took a break the following year, only to reunite years later. The two Berggren sisters left in 2007 and 2009, respectively, and were replaced by Clara Hagman and Julia Williamson. They weren't the same band anymore. Ulf Ekberg, the founding member and keyboardist, was nicknamed Buddha and was very apologetic about his younger years when he was involved with a neo-Nazi group. Now he's a businessman and lives in Stockholm with his girlfriend and 3 children. A reunion? Ekberg said, with the right elements in a few years, I don't think it's possible, he told ABC News. He said, there's a few things that have to come together. First thing, he did point out that Lynn would not be part of it because she's not in the music industry anymore. She left the band and we asked that she never asked to come back. She's completely done. And in interviews, Lynn did point out that she never really wanted to be famous. Lynn was the principal lead vocalist of many of the group's earlier singles and their first album. And then she started splitting the singing and songwriting duties with Jenny. She really kept the details of her personal life very quiet, unlike the other members. Lynn officially left the group in 2007 and pulled out of the limelight. Jenny Berggren was also lead singer of Ace of Base, and she also started stepping back. There have been a lot of different incarnations. In 2007 to 2009, for instance, Jenny, Jonas, and Ulf performed a series of concerts in Europe and Asia. They planned on a new album, but did not get a recording contract. That's when Ulf and Jonas started looking for new singers. And again, we must say, it just wasn't the same anymore. Talking about Jenny, Jonas says of his sister that she never really said, I quit. But to the record company, he says she was a leading member, so they canceled her contract. Getting closer to present day, in 2016, Berggren stated, we won't reform. We're finished working together. But we're not finished being a family together. We have a lot of fun plans in the future, but no musical plans. Jenny continues to reside in her hometown of Gothenburg, Sweden, with her family, her husband. Jonas Berggren, known as the Joker, wrote the group's biggest hits, including All That She Wants, The Sign, Beautiful Life, and he was usually playing guitar and keyboards. In 2009, he started a new producing publishing company. So that band probably will never get back together again. What a string of hits, though. Ace of Base influenced a lot of big artists that we know today. Lady Gaga. She even said Alejandro was influenced by Ace of Base. Katy Perry said her 3rd album, Teenage Dream, was influenced by songs like The Sign. And Tegan and Sarah's song Closer was also inspired by Ace of Base. It was good while it lasted. Hope you enjoyed that. Make sure you comment on our video, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos. There's also a link in the description where you can hear our podcasts, which are our long-form interviews, where we just chat and chat with great musicians in the history of rock and roll. Also, pick up a t-shirt. There's links in the description where you can pick up a Rock History Canada, Rock History book, or Rock History Music t-shirt. They're very nice as well. I'm John Beaudin. Take good care of yourself.